Welcome to another presentation about the Carolina Bays. I have been programming computers for over 50 years. Computer programming has taught me some tough lessons about Boolean logic. A computer does not let you get away with logical errors. If you have not formulated the program correctly, the computer will not give you accurate results. These fundamental principles of logic are also useful in formulating correct linguistic statements, and for this reason, I want to expose the Thermokarst fallacy in geology. Some geologists have proposed that the Carolina Bays are identical to thermokarst lakes that form in permafrost, and therefore that the presence of Carolina Bays implies the presence of permafrost at an earlier time. The premise is false, and therefore any conclusions reached from this premise are also false. A technical report by Raymond Kocharovsky from 1977 has been cited by many authors, even though the report was never published in a geological journal or subjected to peer review. Kocharovsky proposed that the Carolina Bays were identical to thermokarst. His report starts by saying, quote, "The origin of the Carolina Bays has been something of a geological enigma since their existence on the coastal plain was first recognized in 1848. Theories that have been proposed for the origin of the bays are numerous and diverse. Surprisingly, however, most workers seem to have neglected the concept of uniformitarianism in their studies of these remarkable features. Hence, few investigations have been designed to compare or contrast the Carolina Bays with modern analogs in Alaska, Chile, and Texas." End quote. This report was written before LIDAR gave us clear images of the Carolina Bays and before the 2001 publication by Zanner and Kuzila that identified elliptical structures similar to the Carolina Bays in Nebraska. I have already mentioned in some of my earlier presentations that Professor J. Meloche classified the Carolina Bays as thermokarst lakes in his book about planetary surface processes. The Carolina Bays are mentioned in the context of active thaw lakes that are found in northern Alaska and northern Russia. These thaw lakes are formed during periods of climatic warming when permafrost melts, causing the land to sag and create ponds that fill with meltwater. Christopher Suisse is a research geologist at the U.S. Geological Survey in Reston, Virginia. Publications from the staff of the USGS are generally accepted as authoritative, so his opinion that the Carolina Bays are like thermokarst is very influential. In 2020, Suisse wrote a chapter in a book about aeolian dunes and sand sheets of the Atlantic coastal plain. One paragraph reads, quote, "The southern limit of continuous permafrost during the last glacial maximum is generally thought to have been located in central or northern Virginia, approximately 230 to 320 kilometers south of the last glacial maximum ice margin." French et al., 2009, French and Miller, 2014. But the distribution of Carolina Bays suggests that permafrost, possibly discontinuous and or sporadic, may have extended much farther south. End quote. In order to write this, you really have to believe that the Carolina Bays are thermokarst lakes, but this leads to the thermokarst fallacy in geology. The premise is that the Carolina Bays are identical to thermokarst lakes that form in permafrost, and the conclusion is that therefore, the presence of Carolina Bays implies permafrost. Notice that Suisse justifies the conclusion that the Carolina Bays originate from permafrost by hypothesizing that the permafrost was possibly discontinuous and or sporadic. This justification is particularly troubling because in the same sentence immediately before, Suisse has cited two publications saying that the southern limit of continuous permafrost during the last glacial maximum was located in central or northern Virginia. A false premise leads to a false conclusion. If we say that cats are identical to barking dogs, then we can conclude that the presence of cats implies barking. Someone would say, wait a minute, that is ridiculous. Dogs are not the same as cats. We could then point out that dogs and cats have many similarities. They both have four legs and a tail. However, after conducting a careful examination, we would have to conclude that cats are not identical to barking dogs. It is the same situation with Carolina Bays and thermokarst lakes. Once we examine both of them in detail, it becomes evident that equating the bays to thermokarst is a false premise. A paper by Lundin and Trembanis published in 2021 points out that the Carolina Bays have been compared to thermokarst or thaw lakes in the Arctic due to their similar appearance as oriented elliptical depressions. The paper references Kocharovsky and Suisse. But then, Lundin and Trembanis explain, Quote, the maximum relief of tall lakes, rim apex to bottom of basin, often exceeds 10 meters, much greater than the maximum relief results reported for Carolina Bays. Again, if the Carolina Bay basin deposits are removed, their maximum reliefs are only increased by a few meters, still much less than that of the typical thaw lake. The presence of permafrost, a prerequisite for thermokarst formation as far south as the coastal plain of Georgia, seems unlikely even during prior glacial maximums. It also is not supported by proxies, nor is it supported by model predictions of past permafrost extents. End quote. Lundin and Trembanis conclude that the Carolina Bays are not identical to thermokarst on the basis of their maximum relief of thaw lakes compared to the bays. Lundin and Trembanis use two references to justify the statement about the southernmost range of thermokarst, and one of the references is the same one used by Suisi. This is the paper that is cited by Lundin and Trembanis, and also by Suisi. The paper discusses permafrost at the time of the last glacial maximum in North America, and it has a map that shows the extent of past permafrost south of the last glacial maximum. The map shows some permafrost in Virginia, but there is no permafrost along the Atlantic coastal plain in North Carolina or in South Carolina. The permafrost in these states was found only in the Appalachian Mountains, but there was no permafrost where the Carolina Bays are located. In spite of the dissenting opinions that we have just discussed, the article in Wikipedia about the Carolina Bays says that most geologists today interpret the Carolina Bays as relict geomorphological features that developed via various aeolian and lacustrine processes. The Wikipedia article calls the Carolina Bays relict thermokarst lakes. In other words, the Carolina Bays are the remains of previous thaw lakes that originated from permafrost. The Wikipedia article cites the recent work by Suisi from the U.S. Geological Survey. As mentioned before, publications from the staff of the USGS are considered authoritative, so it is not surprising that Wikipedia used Suisi's article as a source of information. It is a shame that the Carolina Bays are not studied more carefully, because the Carolina Bays are definitely different from thermokarst lakes. In addition to the maximum relief criteria used by Lundin and Trembanis, the Carolina Bays have mathematically elliptical geometry with raised rims, and they are oriented toward the Great Lakes. Thermokarst lakes have circular to elongated shape, they form as sinkholes, and they are oriented toward lower terrain. This is why it is important to fit ellipses by the least squares method to distinguish Carolina Bays from Alaska thermokarst lakes. The Carolina Bays and thermokarst lakes may appear similar, but if they are not elliptical with raised rims and oriented toward the Great Lakes, they are not Carolina Bays. And let us not forget about the Nebraska rainwater basins, which have the same mathematically elliptical characteristics as the Carolina Bays and also are oriented toward the Great Lakes. We can conclude that the Carolina Bays are not identical to thermokarst lakes and that the presence of Carolina Bays is not indicative of permafrost. The precise elliptical geomorphology with raised rims of the Carolina Bays is a significant clue that the bays originated as inclined conical cavities or penetration funnels, as can be demonstrated by impact experiments. Thank you for joining me in the investigation of the Carolina Bays and the Younger Dryas Cataclysm. There's a link to the LiDAR visualization tool in the description of the video. My book about the Carolina Bays is available at Amazon. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel to be notified of future videos about the Carolina Bays and other scientific topics.